So we have another Star Wars the Black Series action figure to review. So this is the deluxe version of Boba Fett based on the Star Wars Return of the Jedi movie. So this is number 06 of the series. So this is the figure of Boba Fett out of packaging. So I have been playing with this figure for 1 hour. So the first thing that I really did was to really inspect the details of the figure without subjecting the joint areas to heat first. So good job Hasbro on really putting a lot of fine details on the figure. So especially the battle damage effects, because the battle armor of Boba Fett really looks like it has seen better days. So we have a lot of bullet or blaster holes on the helmet, on the chest area or torso armor. We also have this paint weathering effect on the armor gauntlets, the shoulder protectors, and the front, and the battle effects or the worn out effects is not only concentrated on the front of the figure, but we could also note that it's also on the back of the figure, because if you would look at the back of the helmet, the back of the helmet is also worn out. The paint area is also worn out. So with the cape, because if you would look at the cape closely, there are holes on the cape. And I thought that Hasbro was just cheapening on the plastic by putting holes on it. But on closer inspection, I noted that the holes are not even, and they are not evenly shaped. They are not perfectly round. So some of the holes are spaced or looks different, as you could see over here. That's a different shaped hole. So with that, that's a different shaped hole. That's a different shaped hole. So looks like that the cape was really worn out and bullets were passing through it. So good job Hasbro on the amount of detail that you put on this figure first. So the next thing that I would like to talk about is the articulation of the figure. So first I subjected the figure to heat to really loosen up the joints, because in packaging it was really stiff. So I had to subject the area of the joint areas to heat. Okay, so we have rotation for the head. We have good articulation for the arms. We have a hinge for the arm, for side, for front, back, and side motion. We have a single point of articulation for the elbow area. We have rotation for the forearm. This gauntlet can rotate. So with the hands, the hands could rotate and it has a swivel. So same goes for the right arm, the articulation. Now as for the torso area, we have a ball joint on the torso. So we have this motion. Now I discovered that we have a cut over here, but I subjected that area to heat and I am not getting any point of articulation over here. So I think that is just a point of connection. So it's not an area of articulation, because it only rotates over here. But as I try to really rotate the waistline, it doesn't budge. So that is just, I think, a point of connection for the figure to connect the top part and the lower part of the body. Okay, so for articulation for the lower area, so we have this motion for the leg, so he could kick this high up front and he could kick that high on the side. So the belt is floating so as to give proper motion for the leg area. Now we have a cut on the thigh over here for rotation, a single point of articulation for the knee, so just a single point, and a hinge and a swivel for the foot. So that is the point of articulation that we have for this Boba Fett figure. Okay. For the hands area, this is a pistol gripping hand. So as you could see, the finger is separated from the rest, so as to let this finger rest on the trigger guard of the pistol caliber carbine, the PCC of Boba Fett. So on close examination of the left hand, I also discovered that this is a pistol gripping hand. However, it does not have the cut of the right hand. So what I did was just to subject that left hand with through the X-Acto knife. So I just cut through this finger. Anyway, it's soft rubbery plastic, so as to free that finger and let Boba Fett handle his PCC either left or right handed. So that is for the articulation for the figure. So let's examine the accessories that come with the figure. So the easiest first, so this is the accessory that is for the left forearm, which is the flamethrower effect. So it attaches well to the left gauntlet, to that point over there. So let's take this accessory to the side. Now we have the jetpack. So the missile attaches and detaches from the jetpack. So thank you, Hasbro, for that. And we could really see a lot of weathering on the jetpack. So these two accessories attaches to the ends of the jetpack. And to note, we have rotation on the individual thrusters of the jetpack, so you could put it at an angle, a certain angle, as to not burn the cape of Boba Fett. So let's put this accessory to the side. Okay, also not to mention, it has three access points or connection points, so this jetpack won't be wobbling side to side on the back of the figure. So those are the three holes that connects this piece to the figure. Okay, next accessory we have are the PCC, or the pistol caliber carbines, or pistol laser carbines if based on Star Wars lore. Okay, so this is the intact one, or the whole one. This is the thing that I subjected to heat because the barrel was crooked, so I had to really place it on the with the hair dryer to straighten the barrel and the stack. So now it looks nice. Put that aside. Next thing is this PCC, or pistol caliber carbine, that is detached or comes in halves. Now that is to give the effect that Luke Skywalker cut through the pistol caliber carbine of Boba Fett. Now straight out of packaging, this barrel part would really not attach well to the stuck at the rest of the weapon, because this area over here was just way too big that it didn't fit well. So I just had to subject this peg to my X-Acto knife and cut through a little bit of material on each side, so as to gain this effect right now, where the two halves would really join well. Okay, so if you would want to have a dual pistol caliber carbine wielding Boba Fett. It's possible. So if you are expecting to own this Boba Fett figure for a very long time, then it's your choice whether you want to glue these two pieces together and paint that area black or brown as to hide the effect that it is in two pieces, because we could have Boba Fett wielding two PCCs like his father, Jango Fett. Jango Fett wielded two pistols, so why can't Boba Fett wield two PCCs as well? The last accessory that we have is the grappling hook. So this grappling hook attaches, the point of attachment is this thing over here. So that attaches to the right forearm over here. However, it is on, the grappling hook is on a string, this string. So we cannot really achieve that proper effect that Boba Fett shot this grappling hook this way. So what I did was just to take the string off and took out a wire, a twist wire, or you could even use something like this if you want something thinner. So this is a floral wire, which I later would be using for this accessory for Boba Fett. So we could achieve this effect that he's able to shoot the grappling hook. So let's discuss other points or areas of the on the figure that is worth mentioning. So let's start with the head sculpt, the head area, because this piece over here, you could put it down like this to give Boba Fett that effect that he's peeking through his range finder. So that piece could be lowered onto the right eye. Okay. Now, this area over here on the left forearm. Now, when I played with this figure for about an hour, I somehow would guess that these three plastic pieces would somehow get ripped later. So just be careful when playing with this figure, because you might be able to just cut off any of that three pneumatic wires or whatever when bending the elbow. So you have to place the forearm at a certain angle so as not to break any of those wires or stress them out. So that is just a bit of other information for the details of this really fine Boba Fett figure. So let's attach the accessories and get some videos and pictures of the figure.